Today I'll be talking on the subject, stick to the right standard. This year I want you to set the right standard for yourself and stick to it. The right standard is the God's will for your life, what God has ordained for your life. Stick to that right standard. God has promised that we will enjoy bliss in our marriages. Stick to the right standard. God has promised that He will give you the right person to get to marry. Stick to the right standard. Don't compromise that standard. Oh, people might want to talk you out of it. You want to say, oh, the standard you're expecting doesn't exist in this generation anymore. I am telling you, they still exist. That standard still exists. If God has said it, then it still exists. He has a way of working things out together for our good. Oh, they want to tell you, oh, there are no longer faithful men out there. All men cheat on their wives. But I'm telling you, there are still men that are faithful. There are still men that are faithful and ready to be with you. Oh, they want to tell you, all women, and they are no longer decent women. All women are materialistic and socially intoxicated. They are no longer women that are ready to be patient to build with you. I am telling you, there are still good women out there. Your own is still there. Your own husband is still there. Your own wife is still there. I mean the right ones. The right, the ones with the right values and the right principles of life. The ones that you are hoping for. The ones that you are expecting according to God's will and desires for your life. And you must understand this. You must wait for it. You must stick to it. You know, at the point in Elijah's life, he got to a point and he felt, oh, he's the only one that's remaining. He's the only righteous person that is remaining. And God had to tell him, oh, there are still 7,000 men that have not bowed their knees to Baal. And you must understand, he wants to tell you, what you are expecting doesn't exist. What you are expecting doesn't exist anymore. I want to tell you, if God has said it exists, then it does exist. And you need to stick to the right standards. A lot of people have given up hope on the reality of heaven on earth marriage. In fact, some people think heaven on earth marriage is only a mirage, it's only a propaganda, it doesn't exist anywhere. I am telling you, it does exist. I'm a witness of it. It does exist. You seek to it. You believe God for it. You position yourself for it. You prepare for it, and you will enjoy it. Because God is faithful to His word. Say, whatsoever a man sow, that is what he will reap. And that is what you need to understand. You need to expect the right things this year. You need to expect that the right man will come to you. You need to expect that the right woman will come to you. You need to expect that you will enjoy bliss in your courtship, in your relationship. You need to expect that you will enjoy heaven on earth marriage, even in your home. I don't know where the situation of your home presently, but I'm telling you, there's still a room for a turnaround. God can still do immeasurably, abundantly, more than all you ask or can even imagine, according to His power that's at work within you. You must understand this. Don't stick to Leah because your Rachel seems far-fetched or because you have suffered betrayal. Don't do that. If Jacob has said, I served 7 years to get Rachel. But it seems this Rachel seems far-fetched. Let me just settle for the layer. I've suffered betrayal. Let me just settle for it and wallow in my pain. Probably will have suffered depression for the rest of his life. Because what he desired, so much desired, he couldn't get it. But Jacob didn't do that. Jacob still pressed on. He stuck to the right standard. And he was able to get the Rachel. It took some time, but he was able to get his Rachel. And I'm telling you, if you can wait patiently, and if you can believe God through the right things, you will still get your own Rachel. You still get your own right partner. You still get your own Isaac. And you must understand this. Stick to the right standards. But I must warn you here, you may have to stand alone. You may have to fight being alone, because a lot of people around you may not believe for what you are believing for. And that is why, if you find out that your circle, even your circle of friends, you are the only one held out, then it means that you need to change your environment. You need to change your circle of friends. You need to modify it. You need to modify it so that you can be with like minds. Sometimes it's hard to get the right circle to be with of like minds, but you need to, even if it takes you to stand alone, please stand alone, sticking to the right standard. Expecting the right things, believing God for the right person, for the right partners, for the right atmosphere and environment in your home. Two things you need to do to get these things, to get what you are expecting from God. The first thing is for you to keep believing. Trust God that God will do that which He has said He will do. Trust God that He will bring to you the reality of that right standard. Trust God that He will bring to you the right partner that He has ordained for you. Trust God that the right man will come to you. Trust God that the right woman will come to you. Trust God that you will enjoy the realities of heaven on that marriage. Believe God for it. If you can't believe, if you can't see it, you can't handle it. John, in the book of John, John said something. He said, the things that we have seen, the things that we have heard, the things that our hands have handled. If you can't hear it, if you can't see it, if you can't believe God for it, then you cannot handle it. And that's why I'm telling you, you need to see that it is possible. You need to see that it is visible. You need to see that it is accessible. Some people want to tell you, oh, heaven on earth marriage is only a mirage. It doesn't exist in our generation. There's nothing like that. It's only a propaganda. I am telling you, that is far from the truth. Heaven on earth marriage it exists. That is God's standard for our lives. That is God's expectation for our lives. When God was about to create a partner for Adam, He said, it is not good for the man to be alone. I will make for him an helper suitable. God said, it is not good. God wouldn't have intended to make the situation to be worse than it was. He wanted to make it better. And that is why marriage is designed to better your life. Marriage is designed to improve your life. Marriage is designed to get you to take you further in life and to get you to the right place that God has ordained for you. And that's why you must believe that God ordained purpose, God ordained what's ideal for every home is heaven on earth marriage. And it is accessible, readily accessible. But the first thing you need to do is to believe God for it. Then the second thing you need to do is to position yourself correctly to receive it. Positioning is very, very important. God had to tell Elijah, go to the brook of Cherith. That is where your supply will come from. You need positioning. Rebecca was well positioned where the servant of Abraham will find her for Isaac. The servant was well positioned where he will find the kind of woman, the category of woman he was looking for Isaac. The right positioning. You need to position yourself correctly. Position your mind. Position your mind to believe that heaven on earth marriage is the reality. Heaven on earth marriage is accessible. Heaven on earth marriage is also accessible for you and to you. You must understand this. You must believe. You must position yourself correctly. Position your mind correctly. When your mind is positioned, that your spouse can also change. Your spouse can improve. Your spouse can get better. Irrespective of the situation of the presentation of your home, things can still work out for your good. You need to position yourself correctly. You need to position yourself correctly. And in positioning yourself, apart from positioning your mind correctly to believe God for the right things and to expect God expect the right things from God, you also need to take the right steps. That's also part of positioning. One of my favorite scriptures says in Matthew chapter 7, verse 12, it says, whatsoever you want others to do unto you, the message says, take initiative and do unto them. So you want your spouse to get better, you want your spouse to be more emotionally available for you. Please take initiative to be more emotionally available. You want your spouse to give you more attention, please take initiative and give more attention to him or her. That's the way to go. That's how you enjoy the realities of the right standards that you have set for yourself. The Bible says the expectation of the righteous will not be cut off. And I believe God, as you set the right standards for yourself, for your relationship, for your home, for your marriage this year, you will begin to enjoy the realities of the standards you have set for yourself. You begin to enjoy what your expectation is from God. You begin to enjoy it because I am so assured that the word of God cannot be broken. And He says the expectation of the righteous will not be cut off. This year is going to be a great year for you. It's going to be a great year for your relationship. It's going to be a great year for you in your marriage. And that your spouse will turn out good. That your home will be blissful again. That your home will enjoy heaven on earth marriage again. And you will be the envy of all. Those people that try to talk you out of sticking to that right standard, they will come to you. They will see your glory and they will behold your glory. And they will come to you. And he will ask you, how did you do it? Because God has made all things good for you. I trust that you have been able to get something on this episode today. Till I come your way next week or some other time, stay blessed. God bless you. Stay safe and bye for now.